Ocelot. I hear they started calling you Shalashaska in Afghanistan. What's that about?
You know the term Shalashaska? It's slang for a suspicious, hastily thrown together organization. The word became associated with a type of forced labor facility in the Soviet Gulag system. OKB scientists and engineers who'd been convicted of crimes were sent to a Shalashaska for forced R&D. The Shalashakas were supervised by Lavrenty Beria of the NKVD, the secret police, under the official name 4th Special Department.
Forced research? That's not very different from what we do here.
Diamond Dogs is different. Everyone here believes in you. Regardless of where they came from or why they're here, they revere you. And they're fighting because it was their choice.
And if it wasn't, they'd leave?
Who knows? That's our reality here, whether it's real or not. If there's another truth, I don't want to know it. All that matters is that's the concept that's taken shape in their heads. The traces of a group ideology, our superstructure, to put it in Marx's terms.
All right. Go on.
Right. So anyway, at some point the enemy started calling me Shalashaska. This was after the war in Afghanistan broke out. While I was keeping an eye on you in that hospital, I was also heading up interrogations here. The men I broke gave up their comrades and families, everything they wanted to protect the most. No real cause for it. I just let myself get caught up in the old Russian pride. And suddenly I received the honor of becoming special interrogation advisor to the forced labor camps. But the more men I interrogated, the more people saw me as just that, the interrogator. It helped cover my real objective of keeping you safe.
You went that far for me?
Far enough to keep you alive. I ended up being pretty well known among the Afghan guerrillas. Some of them would have seen me on the battlefield. And that's how I got the second half of the name. Shalashaska. It's a sword. A type of saber from the Caucasus. Russian dragoons and Cossacks carried them into battle. Now the Russian Empire had a general by the name of Fyodor Artorovich Keller. His bravery earned him the nickname Russia's Greatest Shalashaska. Someone must have known about that. Because somewhere along the line, Shalashaska got stuck on the end of Shalashaska. The guerrillas were using the name amongst themselves. And by the time I got to hearing about it, pronunciation had wound up as Shalashaska.
So half Gulag, half hero sword. It was a perfect fit.
But you see how rumors and ideas about people can get out of hand fast. Once you create a character and put it out there in public mind, it warps and twists with every baseless rumor. And before you know it, all people see are phantoms. In my case, it works out just fine. I'm plenty used to working under aliases.